Now, after Facebook, U.S. lawmakers are now shifting their scrutiny to TikTok. During a congressional hearing, a TikTok executive denies giving information to the Chinese government as privacy concerns hound the video sharing platform. TikTok also said data of American users are stored in the U.S. with backups in Singapore. The company added it works quickly in taking down content that can be misused to harm kids and promote destructive acts. The hearing is part of a lengthy inquiry into what lawmakers see as big tech's increasingly negative influence on competition, society, and children.
I've made no secret about my concerns that TikTok, which is owned by Beijing-owned ByteDance, is paving the way for the Chinese government to gain unfettered access to our children and teens in TikTok, despite vague assurances that they, and I'm quoting, store data outside of China, end quote, has not alleviated my concerns in the slightest.
We do not share information with the Chinese government. Just to be perfectly clear, there's not involvement from the Chinese Communist Party in moderation of TikTok, and it's all done by Americans from within the United States.
Former U.S. President Donald Trump had sought to bar TikTok from U.S. app stores over national security concerns. His successor, President Joe Biden, later revoked the plan but sought a broader review of various foreign-controlled apps. Asian markets are trading mixed this morning as investors weigh the latest earnings reports in the U.S. amid lingering concerns on inflation and China's property sector. As you can see, Japan's Nikkei 225 and South Korea's Kospi Index are in the red this morning, but shares in Australia are managing to buck the slide. Now, over in China, authorities are urging billionaire Hui Kaiyan to use his personal wealth to help solve Evergrande's debt crisis. China also calling on other companies to make preparations to meet payments of their offshore bonds. U.S. stocks closing modestly higher on Tuesday, but the gains were subdued as Facebook shares fell in the wake of its quarterly earnings, which was a big miss. Facebook shares dropping nearly 4% after it missed Wall Street estimates for its third quarter revenue as Apple's privacy changes weighed on its ad business. Facebook was the biggest drag on the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ, but the S&P 500 still managed to hit a new record close at 4574 along with the Dow. The NASDAQ also inching higher on the data front now. U.S. consumer confidence unexpectedly rose in October to 113.8 as concerns about high inflation were offset by improving labor market prospects.
So clearly there's been some excitement around a whole bunch of different spaces, whether that's the EV space and some of the tech names recovering. I guess it's a little bit the same way that the markets can't figure out how quickly to get Tesla to $1 trillion, but maybe car buyers are excited about it too. So it makes a certain sense. But yeah, look, market wants to go higher, going to go higher. I think we're still going to see, you know, trepidation flood through, and I think we'll see more downdrafts, but the market still wants to power up.
Taking a look now at U.S. stock futures, seems like it's going to be a muted open there when trading resumes tonight, Manila time. Now, after the bell, two tech giants reported their quarterly results. First off, Microsoft, which beat Wall Street estimates thanks to a pandemic-induced demand for its cloud-based services and gaming consoles. Microsoft's revenue for its fiscal first quarter reached $45.32 billion, up from $37.2 billion in the same period last year. The software giant's revenue from its fast-growing intelligent cloud segment surging 31% to $17 billion. Now, sales in its Xbox consoles also rose, Microsoft shares climbing nearly 1% in extended trading. Now, Google owner Alphabet also beating expectations for its third quarter revenue, coming in at $65.2 billion, thanks to its advertising business. Google's advertising revenue alone rose 43% to over $53 billion in the third quarter.